Wow, we haven't made it to May and we're talking about stuff like this, but it's fun. It's college football talk. So, I was a little confused at first because I guess KREF and other people were talking about SI ranking the top 10 programs of all time. As of right now, I'm recording, it's April 12th of 2024. This article came out at the end of February. So that's how much people know that Sports Illustrated is still a thing. So, in case you don't know, in case you don't spend time on social media, a little graphic is going around about the 10 best teams of all time. And for the most part, this is the part where people turn the video off. I don't have much of a problem with it. I think the top five is actually perfect. You have Bama, SC, OU, Ohio State, Notre Dame. I have been very consistent that if you force me to pick a top five all time, that is literally the top five and pretty much the order I would put them in. And I know people are going to be like, SC shouldn't be that high. And I'm like, eh, if you put them at, honestly, two or three Alabama Natties ago, if you put them at one, I would probably entertain the argument. So, I can put away my hatred and disdain for certain individuals coaching there at the moment or previous encounters in the football field and hand certain programs their flowers. Although people are trying to acknowledge a certain double murderer who just died recently. They want to keep his Heisman trophy in the conversation, but they want to give back Reggie Bush's. I'll tell you what, let's trade Reggie's for OJ's. That way you'll have the same number and then, just. I don't know. Some of you USC people yesterday are f***ing weird. It's like, well, we lost a great Trojan. It's like, no, you don't get to say that. You don't get to separate his college career or even his NFL career. I'm like, well, he was a great football. No. Horrible human being. Anyway, moving on to the actual topic at hand, top 10 programs of all time. So, again, like I said, Bama, SC, OU, Ohio State, Notre Dame, 1 through 5, and I got no problem. Here are the others, like in, I guess I'll go in order. Michigan is there at 6, Texas 7, Georgia 8, Nebraska 9, LSU 10. Michigan's there because of their helmet, let's just be honest here. And they have all these wins against high schools from like 1901 that nobody cares about. Texas at 7, I've always, if there's a blue blood list, like the other blue bloods, in my opinion, are Michigan, Texas, Nebraska. Again, we could argue about that in a moment. Georgia at 8 and LSU at 10. I was resistant to both Georgia and LSU immediately when I saw this. However, Georgia, first of all, this is nothing against Georgia. This is, and what they've done the past few years has been phenomenal. Top 10 all time, no. You can't put them top 10 all time because you have to take everything into account here. Just because they're the dominant program now doesn't mean they just vault in the top 10. No, that's not how that works. At first, I was like, LSU, no. And then it's like, you take into account what they've done 03, 07. They were like a bad, they had a bad day in 2011 against Bama for the second time. 2019, people tried to put that team in the best all-time conversation way too quick. If you want to have that debate, that's for another video. My only issue, this is gonna sound weird because like they have four nat I think they claim four national championships, three of them like this century. My problem with LSU is that they're kind of like a candle that's very violent before it goes out. They put all their eggs in one basket for like 1 year, it seems, and then they just kind of teeter out. There's not a lot of consistency with LSU. I know I'm sure certain programs would gladly trade having three natties over the past 20 years and being so-so here and there and then rebuilding. And but if we're talking about consistency over decade over decade over decade over decade, it's tough. But if you wanted to, honestly, if you wanted to switch like Texas and LSU spots or whatever, I'd be completely fine with that. Again, with Michigan, like Michigan's been dormant for way too many years. I just don't know where you put them. Nebraska's slipping because of the past 20 years of being kind of garbage for the most part. But from Nebraska, from the 60s up through the early 2000s, was one of the programs, period. They didn't win their natties for the most part till the bulk of them till the 90s, but Nebraska was a legitimate threat. from the 60s onward. So, yeah, will they ever come back? Who knows? Again, another topic for another day. I mean, their AD just abandoned them for A&M, so... but yeah, for the most part, I think the fun argument is Ohio State and Oklahoma, because you could flip-flop them if you really wanted to. There's a lot of comparisons. It's like, yeah, like, I mean, Ohio State was kind of dormant for a while. They had some up-and-down years. Like, I don't have a problem with OU being at number three because of the consistency they've had throughout almost all of time of the sport. But Bama, you could put number one because Saban just put them over the top. It's funny, like, I know OU fans on occasion like to prop up that ESPN, like, ranking from, like, the end of the 2008 season. Hey, they put OU number one all time! And then Nick Saban went on to rattle off six national championships at Alabama and totally changed the narrative there. You can't really argue that, unfortunately. But again, Notre Dame at five is kind of like a thing where it's like, they're the Coca-Cola of college football. And some Notre Dame fans are arguing they should be one or two, and like, no, you shouldn't be, because you've been pretty much dormant as a major threat since 1993. So that was kind of the last time you kind of mattered in the grand scheme of things consistently, or you were the team. Oh my God, Notre Dame. Got to watch it for Notre Dame. Notre Dame has been part of the conversation, but no one's really thought they were going to beat anybody. Like, if you want to throw in 2012 was a nice little year where they got steamrolled by Bama, and they've made the college football playoff a few times, and they've never won, and they haven't won a major bowl game since HW was president, maybe? I don't know. That's another thing. This article from SI, by the way, kind of go by its criteria. Who wrote this damn thing, anyway? James Parks, I have no idea who that is, but great job, James. He kind of used the Winsipedia webpage, for those who know those. Winsipedia is a fun little webpage where you can go compare college football programs and see where they rank on things. It's actually a neat little website. He went off winning percentage, national championships, boy, put an asterisk next to that. Conference title games, bowl games, again, put an asterisk next to that. Total wins, bowl record, All-Americans, Heisman Trophy winners, NFL draft picks, AP poll stuff. Here's my thing, and I could go on for an hour on this. Not every national championship in the college football world is equal. Just because Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles quarterly magazine picked you as their best team in 1921... doesn't mean it's more valid than an AP poll title in 1956. So I just want to throw that out there. Newt Rockne was infamous for going to the mathematician Dickinson or whatever his name was and got him to retroactively declare his like 1929 team like the best of all time or something. So you gotta like... The history of this sport and claiming championships and how they were quote-unquote awarded is fascinating. It's really silly and stupid, and people really want to defend this stuff. It's like, it's what makes the sport great, and no, it's what makes the sport stupid. So, I am thrilled we have a system that's a lot closer to winning something on the field now, and we can move on with our lives there. So, yeah, for the most part, I'm not going to yell or scream about this for the most part. You know, you can look at it like you can look at it on KREF's Twitter feed or whatever. But yeah, and I'll put the link of the actual article like in the below down there so you can see it. So again, from February 23rd. So we're really on top of things, KREF. But hey, it's content for the day. And we get to talk about college football and we'll just be waiting patiently for a week from tomorrow where we get to see the spring game. So fun times in Norman again. So anyway, with that being said, if you want to support the channel, like, subscribe, comment, all those good things YouTubers say. I have Venmo, PayPal, and Cash App in the link below. Every little bit helps. It does. So if you want to give to the channel, especially in the off season, guys, I'm not just saying that as a thing. It really, really helps. Like, if you like the content in the fall, it helps support it now as well. Believe me, because July, we're gonna have some fun, but we're not into July yet. We gotta get July is when things become official, and then it's like full steam ahead onto the season. But we're not in July yet, so we gotta get through the softball tournament first, get through spring practice first, all those fun things. So anyway, whoa, I just almost knocked everything off my desk. Fun times. Anyway, Boomer Sooner, you have a good one.